That is absolutely the first time I've gotten applause for doing the superintendent's report. But I appreciate it, and we should come back every single board meeting. It's now with great pleasure I'd like to introduce Mr. John Perilla, Supervisor of the Arts here at East Brunswick, who's going to introduce some of our special students for a performance tonight.
Hi, good evening, everybody. Board of Ed members, Dr. Valesky, members of the East Brunswick community, thank you so much for allowing me to come for just a few minutes and spread some extra joy. I know it's the end of the year and everyone's excited to start their vacation, but as an arts educator, it's always important to make sure that we give back to the community and perform whenever we get a chance. And we want to show our appreciation to the board for all the support you've given us year round. So Dr. Gopal, and he's the director of the High School Orchestra, has some students, and they're going to play a little bit for you. It's an amazing group. I heard their dress rehearsal backstage, which is why we were running down the hallway to get here. So Dr. DePaul is going to speak about some of the students and some of the accomplishments they have and what they're going to be doing next year and the years to come. So, Dr. DePaul.
All right. Good evening, everybody. Thank you, Mr. Perillo. The students that are entering the performance area right now are the top students that we have at the high school. They have been representing East Brunswick at honors ensembles since sixth grade at the region level, state level, wow, all Eastern level, and two different national orchestras, one of which toured China and Korea. So these are really the top level string students, not just in this area, but across the country. So we also have one Churchill student along with us, who will be with us next year. But they will be performing the fourth movement of the Mendelssohn Octet. I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
That was incredible.
What an awesome way to end the last meeting of the regular school year.
Oh, my God.
What I love is I get to see the audience from this perspective, and it's a combination of awe and pride.
That's
because
exactly.
People just can't help but smile.
Exactly.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. if we close our eyes, we were in Carnegie Hall listening to a group of renowned professional musicians. I am awestruck. That was phenomenal.
That's where they'll be in a couple of years.
Yeah, free tickets. Okay. Before we get to the commendations, we have some very special presentations, what we call learning across the district, to give you an idea of what our students and staff have been up to. First off, Sidra Islam and Michelle Lanouet, fifth grade teachers at Memorial. They're going to be presenting research on the Revolutionary War along with their students.
Hi, my name is Michelle Lanouet, and I'm a fifth grade teacher at Memorial Elementary.
Hi, I'm Sidra Slum, and I'm also a fifth grade teacher at Memorial Elementary.
So what our fifth graders have done, they've been working on a special project in social studies, and Sidra's going to tell you a little bit about what we do in fifth grade.
For the fifth grade oral assessment, we decided to do a wax museum. The students dressed up as a colonial person or event that they've been researching, and then they came up with a little paragraph, and they pretended like they were that person, and as people walked by, they would come to life and they would recite what they memorized. So first up, we have Ashley Lax as Betsy Ross.
Greetings. Nothing makes me happier than seeing my flag. Oh, how rude of me. I'm Betsy Ross. I sewed the first American flag and it sure was beautiful. I got interested in sewing when I was just a little girl. You know, I used to be a Quaker. As much as I love peace, their lifestyle just wasn't for me. So I ran away with my late husband, John Ross, and started a shop with him. One night after John's death, George Washington came and asked me to sew the flag. It was amazing. Oh, look at the time. I should probably start sewing again. Bye.
And this is Abby Suarez being Phyllis Wheatley.
I am a woman of my words. Complicated, yes. Different, yes. But memorable, certainly yes. My name is Phyllis Wheatley. No one's really heard of me since I'm a slave. In the 1700s, slaves were supposed to remain uneducated, but I wasn't about to let that happen. Thank goodness that my slave owners were frankly nice. Before, I was an uneducated slave. Susanna Wheatley, my slave owner, and her children had taught me a lot of different languages. I also studied the Bible. Because of them, I became a revered poetess. You might be shocked. A slave poetess? Yes, but I am also a woman. Women and slaves are people too. We should not be treated any different than white men. I, Phyllis Wheatley, proved that slaves and women can be more than what they're expected to be, as long as they work hard for it. Thank you.
Wonderful. Thank you so much for sharing that with us. Great job, ladies. Next up, Mariana Helmold will talk to us about the Pride Fair.
So hello everyone, my name is Mariana Helmold and I am an instructional assistant in special education right here in East Brunswick High School. And I'm here to tell you about a wonderful committee that just began this year called the Educational Support Professional Council. The Educational Support Professional Council is a new EBEA committee dedicated to providing a voice for all ESPs, which obviously I'm one of. EBEA represents over 600 educational support professionals covering instructional assistants, school aides, secretaries, custodians, vehicle drivers, cafeteria personnel, maintenance and grounds, and technicians. From the school bus in the morning to classrooms, cafeterias, offices, and school grounds, EBEA, educational support professionals, are there working for all ages of students in East Brunswick Public Schools. The objective of our committee is to listen to concerns and questions in order to provide a positive work environment. Our committee meets approximately every 6 weeks for an hour, which you can imagine how difficult that is with all the different jobs I just named. But we do keep it to under an hour. And then Florence Tellercio, who is the EBA Director of Support Staff, and Lucy Bortono, who is the ESP Council Chair, meet with Danielle Ruggiero, who is the Director of Human Resources, to debrief and problem solve. We are very excited to have an opportunity to share our ideas and our vision. On April 16th, our committee had a table at the ESP community event at Brunswick Square Mall. We gave out some swag and we had info explaining our different roles in the schools, because many people don't really understand all the different people who fall under the ESP umbrella. We had these shirts designed for us to wear that day. And it was the first time we represented ourselves as a group to the community. Overall, it was a very successful event. I think it's important to mention that a significant number of support staff have an East Brunswick address and have had, or currently have, as I do, children that attend the schools in our district. Because of this, we have an even greater vested interest in the success of our students. East Brunswick support professionals make a large contribution to achieving the great reputation that our schools have. Much of this work is done behind the scenes, as they say. In closing, I am proud to work alongside these intelligent, dedicated, and caring support professionals. I look forward to what our committee will be able to achieve in the future, so stay tuned. Thank you.
Next up, Dalia Elhaj, a memorial teacher, and her students will be presenting their creations that were part of their school-wide social thinking curriculum.
Hello, I'm Dalia Elhaj. I'm one of the art teachers at Memorial Elementary. This year, our students learned about Superflex and the Unthinkables, and after that, they designed their own Unthinkables and came up with strategies to defeat them. The students presenting tonight are Ara Vasanthan, Elise Lippert, and Victor Giraldo, and they'll be showing you their drawings of their Unthinkables and telling you a little bit about them. Thank you.
This is Mr. Doozyhead. He makes people sleep in class and miss directions and not learn anything new. We can defeat him by sleeping early so we are not tired during class, and by taking a bath in the morning so we feel refreshed.
This is Nosy Neri. She makes people get involved in other people's business. We can defeat her by asking ourselves if this is something that concerns us, and by not letting people get in our heads.
This is the masked man. He makes people shy and not want to share their ideas. We can defeat him with self-talk. I have great ideas. I don't need to be shy. And by speaking up.
Thank you so much. I love your ideas to defeat them. That was wonderful. Thank you to all the students and staff who came tonight. Another round of applause.
Yeah, great for job.
And now, we'll come to the part of the evening that I think most of you are here for. We have quite a few resolutions of appreciation, and we're going to start. Okay. Perfect. Thank you. Can I please have a motion for the following resolution of appreciation? Whereas Papa Sincheri has served as a student representative on the Board of Education for the 2015-16 school year. And whereas Papa has faithfully attended meetings, offered insight as a student of East Brunswick, and effectively communicated the Board of Education's actions to his fellow students, now therefore be it resolved that the East Brunswick Board of Education recognizes and commends Papa Sincheri for his time and service to the East Brunswick Board of Education.
So moved.
Second.
Moved by Dr. Cohen, second by Mrs. Lax. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any discussion?
I have, yes. I just want to say that I am so thrilled, especially because my children are in the audience tonight, to get to see this young man. Because if you can be half the student and the person that he is when you get to be his age, I will be a very proud mother.
Can I have a motion for the following resolution? Whereas East Brunswick High School junior Grace Ding was selected to attend the Governor's School of Engineering and Technology, a unique summer residential program for academically talented students. And whereas Grace will spend 1 month during the summer at Rutgers University. These intensive summer programs bring together some of New Jersey's most talented and motivated high school students in a challenging learning environment, exploring new avenues of knowledge and developing additional skills. And whereas this honor, a tribute to her hard work, dedication, and commitment, has brought local and state recognition to school, the district, and to the community. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the East Brunswick Board of Education recognizes and commends Grace Ding for this outstanding accomplishment.
So moved.
Moved by Dr. Cohen, second by Mrs. Lax. Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Grace is not here tonight, but we thank her so much for bringing this honor to herself, her family, and the district. May I have a motion for the following? Following a rigorous audition process, two East Brunswick High School students were among the top student musicians from throughout New Jersey, selected to participate in 2015-16 All-State Women's Chorus. And whereas this selection requires a commitment on behalf of the student that results in many hours of intensive practice with students from all over New Jersey and culminates in performances at the New Jersey Education Association Convention and at the New Jersey Performing Arts Center. And whereas this honor, a tribute to the students' talent, hard work, and dedication, has brought local and state recognition to our schools, the district, and to the community. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the East Brunswick Board of Education recognizes and commends these students and their teachers. Christina Kang. Kajul Bhatt. And their teachers, Zachary Gates, Jamie DeSienna. Thank you. I had the motion. It was moved by Dr. Cohen.
Yeah.
Seconded by Mrs. Lax.
And we all approved
it.
No.
Any discussion? No. All those in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. May I have a motion for the following? Churchill Junior High School students participated in the 2016 New Jersey Science Olympiad with more than 1,200 students from 52 middle schools and high schools around the state at Middlesex County College on March 8, 2016. And whereas two members of the Churchill Junior High School placed first in their event, Invasive Species. And whereas these accomplishments attribute to the dedication and commitment of students and staff have brought local and state recognition to their schools, the district, and the community. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the East Brunswick Board of Education recognizes and commends these students and their advisors for this outstanding achievement.
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Dr. Cohen, second by Mrs. Lax. Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Helen Liu. Eric Yu. And their advisors, Alexandra Bartfield and Beth Logan Shoby.
We didn't know if we're supposed to get in the picture.
It's or fine. Probably better without. No. It's okay.
It was an ocean.
Thank you so much. Can I please have a motion for the following? Students from both Churchill Junior High School and East Brunswick High School participated in the 2016 American Mathematics Competition, the first of two qualifying competitions in high school mathematics that determined the United States team for the International Mathematical Olympiad. And whereas four students from East Brunswick High School scored in the top 5% on their respective exams, thus qualifying them to take the American Invitational Mathematics Examination, the second of two qualifying tests used to determine qualifications for the United States team. And whereas this accomplishment, a tribute to the dedication and commitment of students and staff, has brought local and state recognitions to their school, the district, and community. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the East Brunswick Board of Education recognizes and commends these students and teachers for this outstanding achievement and extends its best wishes as they proceed in this competition.
So moved.
Moved by Dr. Cohen, second by Mrs. Lax. Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. There's the advisors. Going to read the name. This is not working.
From East Brunswick High School, Andrew Chen.
From Churchill Junior High School, Stanley Chen. And also from Churchill Junior High School, Jonathan Shung.
And their teachers, Cheryl Cananico, Alex Giordano, and Juliana Nell. Thank you so much. May I have a motion? Whereas the New Jersey Future Business Leaders of America is a student organization helping to build important career and business leadership skills that are necessary in the workplace. And whereas the East Brunswick High School's FBLA Club attended the New Jersey FBLA Spring Leadership Conference, an exciting conference that includes both valuable leadership workshops and challenging competitive events. And whereas East Brunswick High School's FBLA Club did an excellent job competing in all areas with three first place awards in the following categories: public speaking, global business, and e-business, all qualified to move on to the national competition. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the East Brunswick Board of Education recognizes and commends the winning FBLA members and their advisors for this outstanding accomplishment.
So moved.
Moved by Dr. Cohen, second by Mrs. Lax. Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Would the advisors please come up?
First place in global business, Gotham Balaji. First place, global business, Vinay Gonugandala. First place, global business, Stephen Liang. First place, e-business, Sairam Mandala. First place, public speaking one, Kush Mather. And first place, e-business, Vanessa Sante.
And their advisors, Nicole Penny and Caitlin LeBlanc.
May I have a motion for the following? Whereas students from East Brunswick High School who participated in at least four Central Jersey math competitions and are one of the top 60 scorers qualify to represent the Central Jersey math team at the annual American Regions Mathematic League, which is held simultaneously at four locations in the United States, and whereas eight East Brunswick High School students have qualified to attend the prestigious American Regions Mathematics League competition at Penn State. The competition consists of a wide variety of mathematical topics, including algebra, geometry, number theory, combinatorics, probability, and inequities. It involves almost 2,000 students and teachers from almost every state. And whereas this accomplishment, a tribute to the dedication and commitment of students and staff, has brought local and state recognition to their schools, the district, and the community. Now be it resolved that the East Brunswick Board of Education recognizes and commends these students and their teachers for this outstanding achievement.
So moved.
Second. Motion by Dr. Cohn, second by Mrs. Lax. Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Will the advisors please come up?
Andrew Chen. Derek Coldenow. Outgoing senior, Anthony Parfilko. Stephen Yan. And Victor Zhang.
And their advisor, Cheryl Cananico. And Juliana Nell. Thank you. May I have a motion for the following resolution of appreciation? Whereas our PTAs spend countless hours supporting our 11 schools and more than 8,000 students, contributing greatly to their school communities and helping promote a positive school culture. And whereas our PTAs fundraise extensively so that they may give technology and playground equipment, fund mini grants to teachers, provide scholarships, and so much more. Whereas the PTAs generously arrange for and fund special programs, authors and illustrators, music and dance, history and science assemblies, and workshops that enhance and enrich the learning environment for our students. And whereas all those involved in our PTAs are wonderful examples for our students, modeling good citizenship and the importance of doing one share to make the world a better place. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the East Brunswick Board of Education gratefully acknowledges the incredible support of the PTAs and their dedicated service and devotion to students and staff. Further, be it resolved that the East Brunswick Board of Education would like to extend a very special thank you to the president of PTA Presidents, Lindsay Dabrowski, who has supported and encouraged the PTAs in all of their efforts.
So moved.
Second.
Moved by Dr. Cohen, second by Mrs. Lax. Any discussion? Yes, I have something to say. Mm-hmm. As a former PTA president, I know exactly how much you have given to your schools in terms of time and also sacrifice. I know the nights that your children want you to play with them or help them with their homework, and you're on the phone coordinating the book fair, dealing with parents, maybe coordinating with some of the staff at the school about an event you're doing. Your job is 24/7, and you are really, really special. We have thank yous for the Bow Monroe PTA and President, Jessica Logan. Central PTA and President, Colleen Benowitz. Chittick PTA and President, Kristen Fagel. Churchill PTA and President, Lisa Clark. East Brunswick High School, PTSA and President, Linda Mamora. Frost PTA and Presidents, Barbara Reese and Jamie Wasserman. Hammarskjöld PTA and Co-Presidents, Lisa Clark and Gina Boers. Irwin PTA and President, Jamie Latsko. Lawrence Brook PTA and co-presidents, Jennifer Campanella and John Palmer. Memorial PTA and President, Angela Paglia. Warnstorfer PTA and President, Brooke Keenel. And President of the PTA President's Council, Lindsay Dabrowski. Thank you. Thank you so much. May I have a motion for the following? Whereas all public and private secondary schools in New Jersey are invited to participate in the New Jersey Science League, a competition that consists of 4 50-minute written exams in 7 content areas, starting in January and finishing in April. And whereas 2 East Brunswick High School teams participating placed first in the state in Physics 1 and Chemistry 2. And whereas a student also had the highest individual scores in the state amongst all students competing in Chemistry 1. And whereas this honor, a tribute to the students' motivation, determination, and commitment, has brought local and state recognition to East Brunswick High School, the district, and the community. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the East Brunswick Board of Education recognizes and commends these students and their teachers for this outstanding achievement.
So moved. So
moved. Moved by Mrs. Shaw, second by Dr. Cohen. Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Will the advisors please come up?
The Physics 1 team is actually an AP test, and our students were honors physics students, so I think their achievement is even more remarkable. Andrew Chen. Derek Coldenow. Stephen Yiliang. Stephen Yan. Victor Zhang.
The individual who finished first in the state in Chemistry 1, and it is a huge accomplishment, Selena Zhao. The Chem 2 team, first in the state, Jillian Molling. Lily Wang. And Alice Sang.
And their teachers, Deborah Kretzinger, Leslie Anderson, and Linda O'Kane. May I please have a motion for the following? 18 East Brunswick High School students participating in the nationally recognized Rutgers Waxman Scholars Program, in which they focused on the DNA sequence analysis of genes and have had their research published on the National Center for Biotechnology Information Database, which disseminates biomedical information for the better understanding of molecular processes affecting human health and disease, and whereas scientists from around the world will be accessing the published research of these students for their own research purposes, and whereas this accomplishment attributes to the students' hard work, dedication, and commitment has brought local, state, and national recognition to their school, the district, and the community. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the East Brunswick Board of Education recognizes and commends all 2016 published Waxman scholars and their teacher, Ann Sinelli, for this outstanding achievement.
So moved.
Moved by Dr. Cohen, second by Mrs. Shaw. Any discussion? Dr. Cohen.
I just wanted to point out not only this award, but the last group of science awards that were handed out. We've been up here for a long time, many of us. We see student groups after student groups after student groups, and they all seem to be regularly getting these type of honors, and one group seems to break records year after year. And that just, I think, becomes a tribute, obviously, to the kids. There's no one else did the work, but they did the work. But it's also a tribute to the program here that promotes and expects and keeps raising the bar higher and higher, and they all seem to rise to that bar. And the families that support the projects and the education that we provide here. It's a village that makes a program. We've all said that before. We're all one big community, and they do deserve a lot of credit, but this is extraordinary. Most other school districts, I think, would be hard-pressed to have one or two kids make awards like this, and we seem to have groups of them year after year after year. That is no accident.
Thank you. Anna Sinelli.
Roshni Banerjee. Zane Becker. Deandra Castle. Matthew Sirkin-Sisco. Jeffrey Ho. Ray Hochwald, Kayla Kaplan, Subhita Kartik, Amanda Lee, Ramya Yavuri, and Anthony Sai.
And their teacher, Antonelli. May I have a motion for the following? Whereas at the New Jersey We the People 2016, the Citizen and Constitution Competition, students testified on constitutional issues in simulated congressional hearings, demonstrating impressive knowledge of the Constitution, exhibiting the ability to think critically and express their ideas clearly and articulately. And whereas the following rigorous preparation, 27 East Brunswick High School students in the Advanced Placement Institute for Political and Legal Education class placed first in the New Jersey We the People 2016, the Citizen and Constitution competition for the 28th time out of a possible 29, earning the class the opportunity to represent the state at the national finals, an intensive 3-day competition held in Washington, D.C. And whereas this accomplishment, a tribute to the students' hard work, dedication, and commitment, has brought local, state, and national recognition to their school, the district, and the community. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the East Brunswick Board of Education recognizes and commends these students and their teachers and coaches for this outstanding achievement.
So moved.
Moved by Mrs. Shaw, second by Mrs. Lax. Any discussion? Mrs. Lax.
Okay, I wasn't going to, but Dr. Cohen wants me to show everyone how old I am because I was at the beginning of this program back 29 years ago, and it's still going strong. But I can say that since he is older than I am. And he's right, year after year, it doesn't diminish how proud we are of this program and these students and the staff that guides them to these victories.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Will the teacher please come up?
Okay, thank you. We have some representatives from our class this year. We went on at Nationals to place in the top 10, again, for a number of times that we have, and it's a wonderful opportunity that I get to work with these students. Okay, this is my honor, okay, that I get to work with them. Mohammed Hashmi. Jeffrey Ho. Papa Yao Century. Shashwat Singh. Sarah Swade. And Laura Wagner.
And their teacher, Alan Brodman. Coaches Mark Mondry, Joyce Lentz, and Barbara Mayer.
Thank you.
Thank you again. May I have a motion for the following? Whereas the Rutgers Model Congress is a four-day simulation of the United States Congress, where students become legislators and engage in debate over some of the most pressing issues facing the nation within this year's theme, protecting constitutional rights. And whereas the Model Congress experience gives students the opportunity to cultivate practical skills that will benefit them for the rest of their academic and professional lives, including public speaking, written and verbal communication, team building, critical thinking, and real-time problem solving. And whereas 49 East Brunswick High School students were among the approximately 500 students from the tri-state area attending the Rutgers Model Congress, where the entire delegation performed admirably and were recognized for exemplary written work and oral presentation with the best large school delegation. And whereas 22 students were individually recognized for their work. And whereas this recognition, a tribute to the students' hard work, dedication, and commitment, brought local and state recognition to East Brunswick High School, the district, and the community. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the East Brunswick Board of Education recognizes and commends the East Brunswick High School Model Congress delegation and their teachers' advisors.
So moved.
Second.
Moved by Dr. Cohen, second by Mrs. Lacks. Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. The advisors, please come up.
Thank you very much for the commendation. Please come up to receive your certificate. Michael Allen.
Zane Bucker. Alka Bide.
Siddharth Das.
Nick DiCarlo. Viraj Desai.
Sarah Goldman.
Ian Ho.
Elizabeth Jackson. Sanket Jain.
Ashika Jalagam.
Arzu Kapil. Kayla Kaplan.
Fahim Khan.
Jatin Kona.
Justin Kim. Andriana Lukaitis. Melody Michelli. Jishnu Nair. Kush Mathur.
How are we doing this, guys? Why don't you start second row, Jishnu, on that side, okay? Kush, congratulations.
Christina Nashed.
Bobby Patel. Sydney Robles.
Anthony Saad. Nikhil Satarangane. Rick Sarkar. Kuber Sethi. Aishwarya Singh. Douglas Willig. And Nathan Yu.
And their advisors, Michael Wildermuth. And Mark Mondry. Three rows?
It's a big picture.
Bend down.
I say, let's put the ladies up front. Come on. Either that or get some phone books. Come on. Hey, gentlemen, ladies in the front. Come on. Hey, gentlemen, step aside. There we go. Step aside.
It'll be too late by then. The events of this evening look deceptively easy. I stand up here, stumble over some names, read resolutions, we motion, we second, but it took incredible work and effort to plan this evening. And I'd like to give a very special thank you to the two women who really made this all possible, Beth Warren and Karen Mandler. Before we recess, Dr. Cohen mentioned something very important before. As fabulous and wonderful the accomplishments of these students and our staff, it would not be possible without the support of all of you. They may not realize it now, but the support of family and friends is so necessary and so special. So the board wants to thank all of you for everything you've done to bring them to this point. Thank you so much for coming. We will take a 5-minute recess.